my feel good breakfast show.
Welcome back. You tune into your feel good breakfast show, Expresso, right here on SABC3. So good to be hanging out with you. Thank you very much for tuning in. So good indeed. Now, next up, Shout has joined forces with well-known visual artist John Adams to further its mission to develop libraries in the poorest communities of our country. And to date, 10 libraries have been installed around South Africa.
That is divine. It is unbelievable. Through this unique collaboration, 3 inspiring sculptures were created by John himself of Nelson Mandela using the most common pen used in most schools, the yellow Bic pen. We've all used it, of course, with the blue cap that lasts in my life about 10 seconds because I'll be chewing on it and I'll lose it. The project of creating the 3 sculptures took 5 months, approximately 60,000 to 70,000 Bic pens. That is insane. And 6.5 liters of super glue. Let's take a look.
Wow.
I'm a creative, a visual artist, and been working with Shout, doing some creative art with some funky, I think, mediums. We decided to use pens in this project. This whole sculpture piece and some of Shout's initiative right now, as far as the libraries are concerned, much of it is hinged around the importance of education within South Africa and the future of our nation. And one of Tata's most often quoted phrases regarding education is that education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world.
Wow, that is incredible. John Adams, put a round of applause together for this man.
Thanks.
Listen, very cool. I'm glad to see that you are that you are here, that you're not covered in glue.
Yeah, you're not stuck to one of your sculptures.
It has happened.
That is an insane amount of pens, 60 to 70,000
yes.
big pens, dude. Let's talk about this collaboration with you and Shard. How did that come together in the first place?
So, Danny and his dad and Cabello, we've been friends for some time now. I've been working with him for about 7 years, and most of their campaigns have been hinged around anti-violence and anti-crime, and they've recently split into education. So they've been building these awesome libraries, and I've just been working in tandem trying to raise awareness of the importance of putting these libraries in the poorest of the poor communities.
I love the initiative, and we obviously know, I've known Danny and Cabello for a long time. I'm so proud of their efforts, but I like the fact now that we've kind of moved past kind of band-aid over the wound to what actually causes the violence and the social ills. But can I talk to you just as an artist? Was it weird working with Bic pens? Because this is something that's kind of like in our, you know, most of our lives, in our life story. How did you have to adjust your mindset? Is it a material that you were comfortable using? How difficult was that process?
Well, honestly, it threw me off because most times people ask you, what can you do with a pen? Well, I can sketch, I can draw this. So Danny's dad, Gavin, says, no, John, can you sculpt it? I'm like, hey, Gavin, you're going to need a lot of pens. He's like, 1,000, 10,000. I said, no, more like 100,000 pens. I said, no, I don't think Bic is going to buy into this. And then 2 weeks later, you get the phone call. Bic Paris says, okay, the deal. And in front of your studio is 100,000 pens. And the reality of making that sculpture now dawns on you. So you just have to rise to the occasion in that moment. Yeah.
So we know what it took in terms of the amounts of pens, the amount of super glue. I'm still amazed that you're not stuck somewhere. but what really goes into, what went into really creating these structures? Because, I mean, this is not something that happens every day.
Tata Madiba as
So we thought about two aspects. We thought about Mandela being the one who kind of ushered in a new dawn. But it also ushered a new dawn in terms of the light of education and how important it is to break the scourge of much of the violence in South Africa. And we linked that by using a simple thing called a pen to facet something new going forward and a new outlook that we should have and that we should be introducing to schools, because there's still a lot of illiteracy within South Africa. And we need to address these things, hence the libraries are so important.
It is massive. I think people would be alarmed if they knew the rate of illiteracy in this in this country. What's next? How can we support you?
How we can support is these libraries are going to be built. If people can just go to the Shout website, all our account details are there. We need as much money as possible to build them because we take it to the poorest of the poor. Some of these kids have never seen a tablet before. Some of these kids have never owned their own books or interacted on those surfaces.
Sure. They've never seen a Bic pen.
They've never seen a Bic pen. So we have a few tools that we give them when we go there and also open up the doors to this new world out there.
I love that. John, thank you very much to you and your team. I think it's going to be very interesting to see what you guys are going to be doing forward. But we are calling on each and every one at home. Log onto that website. There's a Shout website where you can go and donate. Any little amount is absolutely
donate
worth
money,
it.
Not pins.
Exactly.
Not pins, guys. This time pins. Not this time. But John, thank you so much. And all
thanks
the best for
being
future endeavors, man.
Thanks so much.